संप्रदाय विहीना जमंत्रहास्ते निष्फलामतः अतः कलौ चत्यारो संप्रदायिनः श्री ब्रह्म रुद्र सनका वैष्णवः कीर्ति पावनः श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल व्हाट अमाउंट ऑफ प्रतिष्ठा यू नीड व्हाट अमाउंट ऑफ मनी यू नीड ऑल यू कैन गेट हियर कम ऑन डोंट रन हियर एंड देयर कम जस्ट near Gurupad Padma. You need not run here and there like mad. How much amount of pratishtha you need, what amount of position you need, how much money you need, everything you can get. You need not run like a mad here and there. Just to come near Gurupad Padma. You can get everything, a source of all, you know, everything. Actually, from Gita, you already know, there is one nice advice by Krishna, Tad viddhi panipatena paripeshana sevaya upadekshanti ti jnanam jnaninaha stattva darshinaha. It is the usual rule. Bhagavan Sri Krishna, Paratpara Akhileshwar, he is speaking in front of Arjuna. Arjuna, if you like to get divine knowledge, if you want to get divine knowledge, then you will have to follow particular procedure which is there in scripture. तद्विद्धि परिपाथेन परिपेषण सेवया उपदेक्षन्ति ते ज्ञानं ज्ञानिनस्त तत्त्वदर्शिनः. दोज आर तत्त्ववादी. देयर आर टू टर्म्स देयर. वन इज तत्त्ववादी एंड तत्त्वविद. तत्त्ववादी मीन ओनली दे आर नोइंग तत्त्व. दे कैन मेमोराइज तत्त्व. दे कैन स्पीक नाइसली. But they cannot realize that tattva. That is called tattva badi. Badi means speak. They can speak. Tattva bid means all tattva, you know, there inside his heart in digested form. He can realize everything what is there. That is called actual tattva bid. Those who can realize tattva and can speak in front of you, then you can feel some kind of reaction inside your heart that, well, I am going to hear something. Today I realize something. Of course, if there is any submission, if there is no question of any submission inside your heart, then you cannot expect in whole life or thousands of life coming, you cannot get tattva, you cannot realize tattva. There is one procedure, Krishna speaking in front of Arjuna, tad viddhi pranipathena. You will have to pay pranipat. Pranipat means prakishto. Perfectly you will have to pay dandavat. What does this mean? Only dandavat is sufficient, this word, why use pranipat? Pranipat means perfect dandavat, perfection in your dandavat. What does it mean? I mean, you are paying dandavat with full submission. You want to, you know, submit everything unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. Perfect submission. Not with a mood of, suspicion. Because if you have any doubt about scriptural analysis, guru, Vaishnava, dham, nam, then you cannot come out successful, because you know already in Gita it is written, saṃśayātmā vināśvati. If you have doubt about the purity of Guru Vaishnava, about Krishna, about His holy name, dham, then you are going to, you know, fall down. You cannot come out successful. So, pranipat means prakishta. Perfectly you will have to pay dandavat from heart. Paripashna means you will have to put question, is one kind of interrogation. Interrogation, you know, if you are putting question in front of Guru Vaishnava to test them, how far he is knowing, let me see, I can put one question, if they can answer or not. This type of question is not allowed in front of Guru Vaishnava. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, those pure Vaishnava, yesterday I also told, yesterday's topics, you know, life and percept of Vano Goswami Maharaj, and first I make background about the quality of Vaishnava, who is Vaishnava, what is the position of Vaishnava, I was speaking all about that. And today's topic is the life and percepts of Ramanujacharya ji. But still today I am making one background before starting my speech. So you see, if you put question in front of Guru Vaishnava with a mood of testing them, then it's not good. It is not pariparshna. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, one pure Vaishnava, you are coming, you want to test him, you want to put some question, but he is a realized soul. You want to ask some question, but he is not bound to answer you. If he can look inside your heart, there is some suspicion, he can keep silence. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, one pure Vaishnava, he is not bound to speak in front of you. It depends. If Krishna give indication, then he can speak, otherwise he can keep silence. But still, those who are coming with a mood of suspicion, they cannot come out successful. Anyway, with bhakti, if you are coming, and still Vaishnava is busy with some seva, nam, not speaking anything, still it is good for you. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if pure Vaishnava not speaking anything, but still if you have the chance to see him or see her, pure Vaishnava, Vaishnavi, is very good. You can get some power. This is the condition, you see. So, pranipat, paripashna, paripashna mean, I can give you one reference, I mean example. Like, you know, Parikshit Maharaj putting question in front of Sukadev Goswami. This is not a question with suspicious mood, not that. Very clearly, Parikshit Maharaj want to go out of this material world, though it is written that Parikshit Maharaj, about Parikshit Maharaj it is written, he is Mahabhagavat. But still he is now put it in such a situation that, you know, is beyond any, you know, question. He is now put it in such a situation that everybody looking at him, what Maharaj want to do at present. Now you know already from Bhagavatam that Parikshit Maharaj putting question in front of Sukadev Goswami Sadguru, and the question is very clear, and he is putting question from heart, not from, you know, brain. Atho prichhami saṃsiddhim yoginam param gurum purusa seha yat karyam niyamanasya sarvatha. He Gurudev, I want to know one thing, I want to put one question. What is the actual duty of a man who is going to die very shortly, what is duty? What kind of bhajan you should do? What is his duty? Can you speak? Atho prichhami sangsiddhim, not to get siddhi. 18 different kinds of siddhi. Ashtasiddhi is there, but 10, another 10 kinds of ditti you can add, in total 18. So 10 kinds of siddhi. But Parikshit Maharaj don't want to speak anything about siddhi. He want to get sangsiddhi. Sangsiddhi means bhakti siddhi. Sangsiddhi means sammak siddhi. Siddhi you can get some for some certain period, but you can lose it. Brahma already speaking in front of Krishna, the Prabhu. We can go up. Somebody can go up and up. But after that he can fall down. Arujya krichena param padam tataha patati adho anadrito yusmat angrayo. They ignore the question of seva of your lotus feet. They like to ignore it. That's why they cannot stand there. They go up, but they fall down. So now, today, I want to discuss about a, you know, gigantic personality, a big acharya, like, you know, Ramanujacharya. I started with the sloka, you know, sampradaya vihinaje mantrahasti nisphala mataha. What does it mean? It is from Padma Puran. It is from Padma Puran. It is written there that if you are not introduced with a perfect sampradaya, then your mantra is not going to come out. You can get mantra, but you cannot come out successful. So sampradaya vihina je mantraha ste nishphala mataha. Four kind of sampradaya already written in Padma Puran. Sri, Brahmo, Rudro, Sanaka, Vaishnavaha, Khiti Pavanaha. Khiti Pavanaha, they can purify this whole world, not whole world, 14 world, they can purify. Four sampradaya originally coming from, one from Sri, one from Madhya, you know, another from Rudra, another from Sanakaha. Sri, I mean from Lakshmi, another from Brahma, Krishna Hita Chaturmukh, through Brahma, you know, and from Rudra and another from Chatusana. This way for sampradaya you can get authentic sampradaya. You can find countless sampradaya now in this material world. But without, you know, accepting one authentic sampradaya, your diksha is not perfect, your diksha is not approved as per spiritual actual scriptural analysis, your diksha is not perfect. So you cannot come out successful. This is the point. Now, first of all, you see, yesterday I told, Vishnu Sami Sampradaya is the oldest. Before Christ, Khristabda, you see, Khristabda, it is, you know, before Christ, long. After that you can get Nimbark, after that Sri, after that Madhya. Madhya is the latest, actually. So, Ramanujacharya is the greatest personality in spiritual world, you know. So, he took birth actually, one place is there, 13 crores away from Madurai. One city is there, in South India, Tamil Nadu, there. There is one village that name is Mahabhutapuri. Mahabhutapuri. There he took birth, Ramanujacharya. And his father is Kesavacharya and mother Kantimoti. Kantimoti, full of bhakti. Very, very pure Brahman. Very, very pure Brahman. South Indian Brahman, Tamil Nadu Brahman, Dravid Brahman. Very pure. So this way he took birth. There is some doubt, but still what Prabhupada speaking, I like to speak that. What Keshava Goswami Maharaj speaking, I like to speak that. Actually, 938 Shakabdo. 938 Shakabdo. He too. But there is some doubt, somebody is speaking something. But anyway, as per, you know, survey, it seems it's good. Right, exactly. After that, actually, it was Panchami. It was Panchami, Chaitra Panchami, and Purnamasi, and not Purnamasi, actually, Panchami. He took birth. Actually, when he took birth, his condition is when the symptom was very good. His symptom was so good, his maternal uncle, his name is Soilopurno. Soilopurno is the maternal uncle of Ramanujacharya, I mean the younger brother of Kantimoti. Kantimoti, mother of Ramanujacharya. So, younger brother of Kantimoti. So he took birth. Actually, Soilopurno is big devotee. He took initiation from Jamunacharya, Jamunacharya. He took initiation from Jamunacharya, big personality, doing nice bhajan. So when he heard that my elder sister given birth, a nice baby, readily he is coming there to see, and after that he is watching all different kind of nice, beautiful lakshan, symptom. After that he is speaking, it is just like Lakshman, the younger brother of Ramachandra. So I like to put his name as Lakshman. So his name was Lakshman Deshik. This way he took birth, and very shortly it was discovered that the merit of Ramanujacharya is exclusive. It's not possible in this material world. Impossible. Within very short time he can memorize all Vyakaran, grammar, Sanskrit grammar, Vedanta, everything. For special Vedanta course, I am speaking after. This way, from childhood, he grows some speciality. Different kind of speciality was found with him. Like from very childhood, he was very, very eagerful to serve Vaishnava. Very small boy. If he watching any Vaishnava paying dandavat, come to my house. And he is child, knowing nothing, but still is always paying respect to Guru Vaishnava. You know, one Vaishnava was there, very pure Vaishnava. He is Kanchipurno. His name is Kanchipurno. Kanchipurno also the disciple of Jamunacharya. Try to remember what I say. He is the disciple of Jamunacharya. First, Soilopurno is the disciple of Jamunacharya, Jamunmuni. That time he was the biggest personality in spiritual world. Jamunacharya, so big devotion. Nobody can expect. He was also the disciple, Kanchipurna was the disciple of, you know, Jamunacharya. But one point is that he took birth in a very low family. Yesterday I also wanted to clarify this point. A Vaishnava can take birth anywhere. It doesn't matter what it concerns to us. Vaishnava is Vaishnava. Vaishnava is the guru of Brahman. Though in scripture you can find Varnanam Brahmano Guru. Varnanam Brahmano Guru. Varnanam means, you know, Shudra, Vaishya, Kshatriya. For all of them, Brahman is only Guru. But when we discuss about the speciality of Vaishnava, there we can break this Siddhanta. This is ordinary Siddhanta. That Varnanam Brahmano Guru. But this is special Siddhanta, that Vaishnava is a Guru of all. Vaishnava is a Guru of Brahman also. So anyway, he took birth in a very low family, low caste, to prove that it is not a matter. That matter is a very small question, no question at all. I mean, in what family he has taken birth is not a big issue. So, actually, he is the disciple of Jamunacharya, I told you. Kanchipurna used to go to Kanchipuram. Kanchipurna, he every day used to go to Kanchipuram to worship Varadaraj. Follow my point. Kanchipuram, one place, there Varadaraj temple is there, and Ramanujacharya's previous home was not very far from that. So anyway, he used to go to Varadaraj Kanchipuram daily through that way. That way, which way? And where Ramanujacharya used to stay previously. Through that road, where Ramanujacharya used to live there actually. So now, almost every day, Ramanujacharya knowing the time, I mean Lakshman Deshi. Now that Vaishnava going through this road. Every day he is waiting in road and paying dandavat. That very small boy, watching Kanchipurna, he could realize he is a big Vaishnava. So fine eyes. He look at him, he could realize a big Vaishnava. So every day he used to pay prostrate dandavat. Sometime he want to do some seva for him. Sometime without the permission of father and mother, he used to invite, today we'll have to take prasadam in our house. Today we'll have to take prasadam in our house. Please. He used to take prasadam. Without permission, ma, mother, today I invite one Vaishnava, big Vaishnava, he can take prasadam. Then he is feeding him nicely prasadam. After that he always wants to get Uchishta. But Kesavajaj is very clever. Hey, what you are doing? It's not good. After giving prasadam, he wants to message his leg. You should not do. Because you are from a very high Vaishnava, high Brahman family. I am very low caste. What you say? Vaishnava is never low caste and high caste. Vaishnava is always pure. No question. Why you are putting this question? We know one Alvar is there. He took birth. Tiruppan Alvar, he took birth in Chandal family. Yesterday I told. Chandal means who is waiting in crematorium ground to get one last to burn and get some money. So he took birth in a very Chandal family. But still, Lakshman Deshik, Lakshman, speaking in front of Kanchipurna, what do you say? Tiruppan Alvar took birth in Chandal family, but all Brahman and all Vaishnava worshipping his lotus feet. Then Kanchipurna become very happy, well. But still, I am from low family, you should not pay. Anyway, up to this point is okay. You give prasad, I'm taking. But messaging leg, I cannot allow. Anyway, this way, very shortly, Ramanujacharya, Lakshman Deshik, growing up, but he feel it necessary, took initiation from this big Vaishnava, Kanchipurna. He expressed his hope, I like to get initiation from you. Well, no! No, I am from very low caste. I like to get, Diksha from you. Please give me. Well, I can go to Bharat Raj and ask permission. And if Bharat Raj giving permission, then I can think about it. Well, he is going to Bharat Raj, paying Lakshman Deshik want to get Diksha from me, but I am very shy. I am feeling shy because I am from low family who already know. So what to do? So in dream, he got one instruction from Bharat Raj. Well, Purnacharya is just fit. You can allow him to take initiation from Purnacharya. Purnacharya is also one big disciple of Yamunacharya. So all the Yamunacharyas, he want to take. So Kanchipurna speaking, I took permission from Bharat Raj, but Bharat Raj giving indication that you should take Diksha from Purnacharya. Well, as you like. Purnacharya where? Where? Kanchipuram or where? I like to go to him. I like to go to him. So now, actually, Kanchipurna speaking him that I can take you to Yamunacharya, his good, my Gurudev. I is going to meet with Yamunacharya Gurudev with Ramanujacharya, Lakshman Deshik. But in the midway, he got information that Yamunacharya leave this material world. Anyway, he was bound to take Diksha from Sipurna because already indication or instruction he got from Bharat Raj. So no question he got. But in the meantime, I forget to speak you one thing. When Yamunacharya, when Yamunacharya was there, already Acharya, that time, Lakshman Deshik growing up, adolescent age just covered. Then father, mother giving pressure on him, you must marry. I like to give you away in marriage. You must marry. To satisfy father and mother, what to do? I don't like to marry, but you will have to do marry. Then he was bound to marry, very small age. And his wife was just full of smartha bicha, not at all devotion, no smell of any devotion and bhakti. But anyway, she is from a good Brahmin family with smartha bicha. Smartha means material bicha, smartha Brahman bicha, as per, Vedic injunction. But what to do? Yamunacharya going to obey his father and mother, got married. But after that, he wanted to take Diksha. After that instruction I already told you. In the meantime, I want to speak something that what happened in his life. He wanted to get special teachings education about Vedanta. On Vedanta you want to do, get some special knowledge. That time he got information that one Vedanta Acharya is there. He is giving lesson about Vedanta. His name is, you know, I forget, just now, I can say. He wanted to get lesson from him. So he is reaching that place. There he started reading from that Vedanta Acharya, but that Vedanta Acharya is from Sankar Sampradaya. He is from Sankar Sampradaya. He started reading Vedanta from that Acharya. But what he is, remember, someday he is giving lesson, but Ramanuja Acharya, I mean Lakshman, they say, cannot tolerate. He is always giving lesson in a very wrong way. I mean, as per the instruction of Shankaracharya, he is giving, you know, teachings. So he is hearing. But he cannot tolerate. One day, Jadavacharya, actually, he is giving lesson on Vedanta. One day, Madurai city, Kanchipuram, there, the king, his daughter, some ghost, catching her, that small daughter. Small mean young, I mean, not so small. Ghost, not at all like to go away, leaving her body. Jadavacharya trying his hard. As per Vedanta, he is doing mantra, this, that, ha, who, ha, doing this way. But that ghost not going. Ghost become very angry. Hey, who are you to chide me? I am not going. What do you like to do? I can kill you. That ghost speaking to him. What you can do? Huh? Actually, in previous life, I know you in previous life, snack. Special kind of snack is, previous life, your previous life was snack life, snack, you know, snack, special snack. We in Sanskrit or Bengali, you see, goshap. Goshap means like crocodile, you can find four hands and leg, like takshak, you know, same, like crocodile, very small. One tail is there, and mouth is just like crocodile, but he is snack. Takshak is also that type. Previously I know. You know your previous life. You are actually go sharp. You are snack. Now you want to fight with me? What you can do? If your disciple, I mean if your, you know, student, Lakshman Desip can give the water wash, then I can go. Then you become very angry. I am teacher, big teacher, Acharya. That ghost like to get the water wash of that, you know, Lakshman Desik, small boy, he feel disgusted. He feel insulted. Boy, it's very bad. Come, let me see. What to do? Jealous, actually. Then they are bound to give the water wash of Lakshman Desik. Then that ghost leaving her body, going away. Otherwise, that girl, when catching ghost, climbing that tree, naked. But king very, very anxious because I am going to give away in marriage my daughter. Who can marry my daughter if somebody knowing that ghost catching is very bad? Oh my God, somehow I can pay any amount. But I want to get rid of this, you know. But somehow he got, you know, free. She got free. Anyway, after that, Jadavacharya teaching Lakshman Desik, but Lakshman Desik cannot accept. Very problem, you see, big problem. Someday, in Chandogya Upanishad, one sloka is there, In there it is that the lotus eyes of Prabhu can be compared with one lotus flower in full-fledged by the sunlight. By sunlight, when a lotus flower in full-fledged and petals, so nice. This is the, you know, actual meaning. But Jadavarjaja want to make a dirty meaning. Kapyasam. Kapyasan kopi mean monkey. Asan mean seat, I mean backside. Monkey's backside is very red. So he wanted to compare with the backside of monkey. Then Lakshman Desh is crying. He was messaging while in the back of Acharya. But when he is explaining this way, then some drop of hot ice, tears, falling down on his chest. I mean backside. He is looking. Why you are crying? Excuse me, you are explaining this point in a very dirty way. How I can accept? What do you mean? No, I mean, Acharya Shankar explaining this way. So I am, you think you are big Pandit? Now you explain. What kind of explanation you can do? You do explain. Then Lakshman Desi with very humble mood. The Gurudev, if we can get this meaning in this way, Kong Pibati, iti kopi, I mean sun. In Sanskrit, Kong Pibati, Pibati means drinking. Kong, sun always drinking water by scorchy sunlight, then water vaporize and sun drinking. This is the philosophy. So, Lakshman Desh is speaking this way, Gurudev, if we can get meaning this way, Kong Jalam Pibati Iti Kopi. Sun. That means sun. As Dhatu, Dhatu means root. Root. As Dhatu is to expose, Bikash. Like, you know, Padma, when sunlight coming, it in full fledged he expresses himself. Expressing. As Dhatu. Kapyasam. This way, Lakshman Desi explaining. So, Gurudev, if he can explain this way, that the lotus eyes of Krishna, I mean Supreme Lord Narayan, can be compared with the petals, full-fledged petals, by sunlight when a flower, I mean lotus flower in full-fledged form, we can compare with their petals. Well, not it is the principal, you know, explanation. As not Gauna. It is Gauna means not vital. But what Shankar speaking, Shankaracharya is vital. Then he stop argument. Another day from Aitariya Upanishad or Taittiriya Upanishad. Aitariya Upanishad, I think. Satyam Jnanam Anantyam. This sloka, Acharya Jadavacharya want to explain. He is explaining in very formless Brahma. Long time he is explaining this sloka. But he want to establish formless Brahma. But Lakshman Desik become very sorry. Gurudev, I cannot tolerate this kind of, you know, explanation. What do you mean? Gurudev, Satyam, Jnanam, Anantyam. Gurudev, I can prove that it means that Brahma, Supreme Lord is, you know, transcendental feature, form is there. Very, very nice form. Then Jadavacharya became very angry. Each and every fraction of second I am insulted by my student. What to do? It's sure in near future is going to crash Shankaracharya philosophy. Very shortly, he is going to crush Shankar philosophy, Mayavad. We cannot establish Mayavad if he is going to live. Anyway, I like to kill this boy. I like to kill this boy so that he cannot come out successful. Then Jadavacharya planning. Okay, my son, all my students and me also, and you also, we like to go to Allahabad to get, birth in the confluence of three rivers, Ganga, Jumna, Saraswati. Do you like to go? Okay, Acharya, I like to go. Then Acharya planning in the midway, Jadavacharya planning in the midway, in the forest, we can throw him in such a place so the tiger, lion, and all, leopardo can eat him up. Very good. They started for Allahabad. But be careful, in this team, there was one friend. Friend means brother, you can say. Sister of his mother. Cousin, you can say. Mastotovai, cousin. Was there, his name was Govinda. Govinda somehow could realize this plot. Govinda could realize Acharya going to make this plot to kill him. Then he, in the midway, in the forest, within fraction of second, speaking this truth in front of him. Because they are not allowing Govinda to mix with him. Because they know somehow if Govinda can inform him, but by the grace of Bharadacharya, Narayan, your fraction of second, they like to kill you, fly, try to go away very quickly. Otherwise they can kill you. Oh, really? Then Acharya watching that Govinda coming late. Govinda, where is Lakshman? Oh, Gurudev, I thought Lakshman already coming with you. I don't know, I am coming. Because I couldn't walk fast. He don't speaking anything about. No, Lakshman not coming here. In the meantime, Lakshman running and running. Always praying to Bharadacharya, Prabhu, I like to serve your lotus feet. Please arrange the situation in such a way I can do your seva wholeheartedly. Then Bharadacharya, then he is, running and running, running. By Acharya, Jadavacharya sending his disciple everywhere. Search! Where he is? I like to kill him. Where he is? But they couldn't trace out. By that time, Lakshman running and running, flying very fast with forest. He was very, thirsty, tired. In the meantime, he took rest under a banyan tree and praying Bharadacharya what to do. In the meantime, he watching one, hunter and wife. Hunter, one hunter and wife from low caste, very low caste, very blackish. They are going. Then Lakshman watching, excuse me, where you are going? Actually, we are going to Kanchipura. Well, I also like to go. Can you? Yes, you can go. After that evening time, when that couple took rest on a tree, over tree, because all animals there. Night time, the wife of that hunter, she expressing that I am very thirsty. If somebody can give water, I am going to die. Then Lakshman wanted to go in search of water. But that hunter was, no, not now, it is night time. Morning time you can go, not now. I cannot allow. But she is thirsty. I am young. I should go and arrange water if she is dying. No, night time you cannot go, morning time. Then in the very early in the morning, Lakshman Deshi going here and there and find one nice well, you know. From there he got water, but there is no pot. Lakshman Deshi is very tall figure. So this way, three times he is coming to that hunter and giving water to his wife, this way. Three times. One, two, three times. Coming and giving. Fourth time, when again coming with water, is finding brother, that hunter and wife vanish. Eh? Where gone? He cannot find. Then he find everywhere they're shouting people. He watching? All people there shouting and doing Jai Narayan, Jai Bharadraj. Where I am? You are in Kanchipuram. Kanchipuram? I was in forest. By the mercy of, you know, Narayan, you already reached the actual spot. Then he was very, you know, praying Dandavat to Prabhu, Prabhu, you saved my life. But in the meantime, because they wanted to kill Lakshman Deshi. It was not their goal, not their, you know, desire to take bath in Allahabad. In the meantime, they come back. They thought, because Acharya thinking in the midway, in forest, some, you know, animal, I mean, already kill him. That's good, nice. But when he come back, a fine Lakshman Deshi is there. You are here, we are searching you for a long time, we are crying for you. Oh, Acharya is acting. Acharya acting like this way. Oh, Acharya, somehow I am here. Well, again you can come to take lesson to me, to teach. I can teach you. Again you can come. Well, I can come. Very politely. Because Lakshman Deshi wanted to give kripa to that fallen Acharya. That's why he is bearing all torture. He is bearing any kind of torture done by Acharya. Acharya requested, again you can come to take lesson to me. Yes, yes, of course I can come to you. Speaking this way, not fighting with him. But in the meantime, that I want to clarify this point. They wanted to, you know, take darshan of Bharada Acharya. I mean, take darshan of Jamuna Acharya. In the meantime, when Lakshman expressing his desire, strong desire to get diksha from Kanchipurno speaking, him, I can ask to Bharada, I already told him. But in the meantime, his determination was so strong that Kanchipurno, you know, he took one plan. I can approach his wife, because his wife is no bhakti is there. I can express this point in front of his wife, because wife is without devotion bhakti. So Kanchipurno expressing in front of wife, you see, I am from a low caste, you see. Yes, yes, I know you are from low caste. So your husband want to take diksha from me is good. No, no, I can fight with him. This way, Kanchipurno dodge him away, pass away. After that, he told him, I can take permission from Bharadacharya Prabhu, and then I can speak you after. First, I like to ask Bharadacharya. In the meantime, I already told you, Kanchipurno in dream got instruction that Purnacharya is the Acharya of Lakshman Deshi. You can give initiation. You can take him to him. Then Purnacharya giving initiation to him, because he wanted to go there and took initiation in this village. After that, Purnacharya giving initiation to him, Pancharatrik Diksha. Pancharatrik Diksha in South India, in all scripture, it is very authentic that anybody taking initiation and taking five kind of reformation, pancha sanskar, five kind of sanskar, as per, you know, Pancharatrik Vidhi, it was very strict regulation was there in South India, especially in Brahmin family. They are very strict. But by that time, you know, he took Diksha, and Purnacharya wanted to take him up to Jamunacharya. But by that time, Jamunacharya already knowing the glories of Lakshman Deshi. His Gurudev, Purnacharya wanted to take him to Gurudev. His Gurudev, I mean Param Guru, his Param Guru. But by that time, Jamunacharya already knowing everything about the glories of that big devotee, Lakshman Acharya, Lakshman Deshi. Jamunacharya realized in very shortly, in near future, I can see that he is a big Acharya in South India, in whole India. So I want to protect this personality, Lakshman Deshi. How to protect? Because anyway he is not going to accept me if I give argument. So he planned one thing. He write one Stotra Ratnavali. And he giving order to Purnacharya, when he is going to take darshan of Bharadacharya in temple, then you can go and recite this stotra. Recite this stotra. Then he started reciting. Before that, I forget one point, with Jadavacharya and all disciples, together with, you know, Lakshman Desik, they went to take darshan of, you know, Bharadraj. That time, from long distance, Jamunacharya saw him. And by the meantime, he already knowing the glories, he is a big personality. In very near future, I can see he is the protector of religion, you know. But didn't speak anything with him. Only see. After that, he planned that this Stotra Ratnavali written by me, if I give to Purnacharya, if he read, sometime he is going to take darshan of Bharadacharya, he can read, and somehow he hear, then he became interested. Who write? This stotra, I am very interested to see him. You want to see him? Then you can come with me. I can take him to Jamunacharya. Then in the midway, he got information that Acharya Jamunacharya leave this material world. Both Gurudev and Sishya, I mean Purnacharya and disciple Lakshmanacharya crying. Their heart, very heavy heart. They are crying because somehow if we are late to reach that spot where my Gurudev is there, I mean, if a smart Brahman touch his body is very bad. So we like to reach the spot very quickly. They run and reaching that spot and find, okay, nobody touching, no smart Brahman up to now, no, nobody coming and touching him. Well, but Lakshman Desi, very surprised to watch three finger of Acharya is folded. Three finger folded and two finger open. Out of his exceptional merit and by the grace of Bharadacharya, he could realize. Why? All fingers open, but three fingers folded. Why? Oh, maybe three desires of this Acharya not yet fulfilled. So I must realize. Then he's asking and taking information from all, you know, disciples and from everybody. Then very shortly, By the mercy of Jamunacharya, by the mercy of Bharatacharya, he could realize three desires, incomplete desires are there with the Acharya. He couldn't get it completed. What is that? First, somebody should follow me. I mean, Dravir, you know, Amnai Dhara, very perfectly. He should be very perfect Vaishnava and guide everybody very accurately. Then, Lakshman Desik promise, Hey Param Gurudev, I promise, I can follow you in toto. I can show the exact way of Dravir Amnai. I can arrange five kind of reformation for all those who are taking Diksha. Because without five kind of reformation, nobody is pure. Ramanujacharya want to prove, without five kind of sanskar, if one Brahman want to prove, I am Brahman, still he is low, he is more, you know, low and low. He is the lowest creature, he is not pure. Without five kind of reformation, sanskar. So he promised in front of Gurudev, my Param Gurudev. Then one finger open, another two. Out of his exceptional merit and by the mercy of Jamunacharya and by the mercy of Bharadra, he is speaking, I can make one Vashya, commentary of Vedanta as per your, you know, heart, Siddhanta. Then the second finger open. Third finger. They are speaking, Parasar Muni writing some Puran, and there are some speciality of devotion, some speciality, characteristics of devotees, speciality of devotion, a speciality of Prabhu, I mean Narayan, everything written there. So, Lakshman Desik one speaking in front of Param Gurudev, I can make one Vaishnava dictionary. Vaishnava dictionary on the basis of that Puran. Then the third finger open. Everybody is, what miracle? How is that possible? The small, you know, he's so big personality. Then after that everybody could realize, after Jamunacharya, he is second Jamunacharya. He is going to dominate the whole Vaishnava world. No doubt in it. Everybody shouting, Oh Narayan, Siman Narayan, Oh Bharatacharya, we are very lucky we are getting, you know, this Acharya. Oh Jamunacharya, you gone, but you leave another Jamunacharya. Second Jamunacharya. Very happy everybody. After that, Lakshman Desik took decision. After Diksha, Lakshman Desik thinking how to know the secrecy of mantra. You all taking Diksha from Gurudev. But if I put question, you cannot speak properly. You cannot speak properly. If I can speak in front of you, what is the definition of Gayatri mantra? Brahman Gayatri, Kam Gayatri, you cannot speak properly. Very, very tough secrecy is there. It should not be expressed in front of common people. Very secrecy. Lakshman Desik is thinking, my Gurudev giving me mantra, not speaking anything about the mystery of mantra. He approached Gurudev, Gurudev, he must speak about the mystery of mantra. You giving all mantra to me, not speaking anything about the meaning of mantra, I mean secrecy of mantra. Gurudev laughing. You can get everything, I bless you, but you will have to go to Goshtapurna, my godbrother, senior godbrother, Goshtapurna. So, Sri Shailapurna, Purnacharya, Goshtacharya, they all are godbrothers. They are the disciples of Jamunacharya. Gurudev speaking, If you want to get the secrecy of mantra, you must approach my younger, elder brother, god brother, Goshtapurna. Goshtapurna is Grihastha, but still so powerful acharya, Goshtapurna. You must approach him. Then he is approaching and crying repeatedly. But 18 times he is cheating him. No, I cannot give. Sometimes I have no time. Sometimes I can ask a Barodacharya. No, no, it is not possible for me to express this mantra. 18 times. 18 times he is cheating him. After 18th time, because he wanted to prove the rigidity. He wanted to prove the rigidity of this, you know, devotee. When I find, oh, so strong devotee, no doubt, without any doubt, he is a weak devotee. Lakshman, you can come tomorrow, very secretly, I can speak all the mystery of mantra. But be careful, don't try to express this in front of public. If you express, then you can lose everything. He can go to hell. Lakshman not giving any answer. Only. Then after the morning time approaching Goshtapurna, very secretly, he is speaking all the glories of mantra. Secrecy of mantra. And after giving instruction of mantra, don't speak anything about this mantra to anybody. I give instruction, but Lakshman Deshik coming to city, I mean Kanchipuram city, informed of 78 disciples in a room shouting and giving this mantra. Close room, not outside people hearing. Then the information, Goshtapurna getting the information, well, why? I give you instruction not to express this mantra in front of anybody. Why you express? You can go to hell. Gurudev, you see, I am very selfish. But one point is that my selfishness, you know, is very big. You are giving this mantra. How I cannot express in front of these people, those who are willing to reach the lotus feet of Bharadacharya. That's why I can go to hell. This very small sacrifice for me, I can go to hell. I am ready to go to hell, Gurudev, you can curse me. Then Goshtapurna go realize the big heart, Lakshman Desi, and bless him. Your heart is so big. You want to go to hell and express this secrecy of mantra in front of thousands of people? Like Narottama Thakur going to city and speaking all about this mantra. You take, and do bhajan. I like to go to hell. You go to Krishna. You go to Krishna, no problem. I like to go to hell. This way, you see, Lakshman Desi expressing the secrecy of mantra in front of all people. Yet still he is protecting the power of mantra. Because if Gurudev is heavy, Gurudev giving me mantra. If Gurudev losing the power of mantra while giving to me, then who is Gurudev? Lakshman Desi giving mantra to 78, at a time. In a room, loudspeaker. Loudspeaker was not there. I'm just joking, shouting. But still, he is not losing the power of mantra. So powerful acharya. Then after that, he took decision how to fulfill. First condition, I can follow my Param Gurudev. I mean Dravid, Sattvato, Sampradaya, I can protect. I can arrange 5 kind of, sanskar, reformation, I already done. But the second promise, what to do about that? I can make one commentary of Vedanta according to your heart. Hey, Param Guru, how to do? Then he took information in this disciplic succession of, you know, Jadavacharya, his Gurudev, Jamunacharya, his Gurudev, in disciplic succession, he got information that, well, Bodhan Acharya, that time he wrote one, you know, indication, not full commentary, but indication, some indication about Vedanta. Each sloka, each sutra, each formula Vedanta, and giving some indication down, footnote. Then Lakshman Deshik took decision, somehow I will have to collect this Bodhan Bhashya. How to collect? He took information, well, this Bhashya is already there with Mayavadi, you know, those who are Mayavadi, they capture it. They are not going to express in front of anybody. Because if they express Bodhan Bhashya, then their Mayavad cannot stand. Don't think that Shankaracharya was the first man to express Mayavad. Don't think like that. Ravan in Treta Yuga was weak Pandit. I should not speak this way that he is Pandit. I should not speak, but I am bound to speak this way. Pandit me? Pandit? Who is Pandit? Krishna Bhagavan giving total instruction to Uddhava. Uddhava, who is Pandit? Uddhava asking, who is Pandit Prabhu? Who is Pandit? Krishna speaking, Pandito Bandha Makshabit. Pandito Bandha Makshabit. He is Pandit who is knowing the secrecy, how to get free of this material torture. He is Pandit. Who, knowing everything about bhakti, he is Pandit. Kamsa is Mayavad Bhashya, you know, Ravan, Kumbhakarna, Lanka Sutra. Keshav Goswami writing, he got one book in Buddhagaya. He saw. There he found that Ravan used to come by plane. Plane means rath, chariot. Almost every day to meet with Buddha, not this Buddha, previous Buddha, to discuss about Mayavad Bhashya. So it is written there. From Lanka, Sri Lanka, Ravan used to come by chariot and discuss with about this Mayavad Bhashya. So Mayavad Bhashya is not new. Maybe by the instruction of Krishna, it was expressed in front of common people, those who are demonic character, to cheat them, to keep bhakti very secretly. Krishna don't want to give bhakti to anybody. Bhakti is very secret treasure. Bhakti is very secret property of Krishna. Krishna don't want to give it to anybody. So in front of Yudhishthira Maharaj, Naraji Maharaj speaking, hey Rajan, Krishna want to give everything, but not bhakti. Even mukti, dadati mukti, small no bhakti yogam. Krishna want to give mukti, though this mukti, as per Gaudiya Sampradaya, this mukti definition is totally different. But here in the sutra, mukti means to get free of this material torture, make me free. Mukti is open term here. But as per Gaudiya Siddhanta, mukti is special, you know, explanation. Muktir hitva anyatha rupam, sarupena vyavasthiti iti mukti. Muktir hitva anyatha rupam, sarupena vyavasthiti iti mukti. This is called mukti. As per this definition of Gaudiya, mukti means bhakti. Without bhakti, actual mukti is not possible. But first discussion I am doing, what is written, that is about the common mukti term. It's common factor. Everybody like to, Mayavadi also like to, So Bhagavan like to give mukti. Take. But not bhakti. I cannot give this property to you. It's very special property. This way, you see, don't think that Mayavad Vasya, just, you know, Shankaracharya is the pioneer man, not that. But anyway, I told you Shankaracharya, I can speak it last of my speech. I can speak about this. We can get information from their sampradaya. Two Shankaracharya. First Shankaracharya lived in his body. He took, you know, birth there in Kerala. Second Shankaracharya, he took birth in Kumbakonam, one place in South India, near Madras. There. I can speak something special about it, not now, because I have so many vast chapters. It's like ocean. I like to speak within short compass, but not possible. Anyway, Lakshman Desik wanted to collect that, you know, Bodhayan Bhasa. By that time, when Jamunacharya gone, then at the bank of Anant Sarovar, in South India, near Bharadvajacharya temple, there is Anant Sarovar. One pond, big pond, Anant Sarovar. Like Kusum Sarovar, this, that. At the bank of Anant Sarovar, keeping the photo of Jamunacharya, Lakshman Desik took sannyas. But before sannyas, one history is there. Nice story. I like to speak this story. You can laugh. You can dance. Very, very nice story. Lakshman Desik actually, one poor Brahman, he is very hungry. He came in the house of Lakshman Desik. Lakshman Desik was just outside his room. He was doing some bhajan. That Brahman going to his house and begging for some prasadam. Can you give some bread or something? I am very hungry. But his wife is very, 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 you know, hard man, hard personality. He is very smart. Hey, go! I cannot give anything. Go away. Don't disturb. The Brahman became very, you know, sorry. Then he is coming in front of Lakshman Desik. What happens? I went to your house to get some prasadam. I am very hungry. But your wife drive me away. Go! Then Lakshman Desik making a plot, very nice plan. Now you can go to my house. No, I don't like to. Hear my plan. Keep patience. You go to my house, you just speak, I am coming from your father's house. You speak this way. I am coming from your father's house with a special motive. Your father like to invite you. Because your father like to arrange your marriage of your father. I mean, brother. So in this marriage ceremony, I am coming to take you. Really? Come inside room. Sit. And take prasadam. Nice prasadam. After this wine. Giving so much prasadam. Very nice. I am now satisfied. Lakshman Desik laughing outside. Then Lakshman Desik only giving him instruction, I am coming here to take you with me. In the meantime, Lakshman Desik is coming. What kind of preparation going on? Actually, you see, my father inviting me. Really? For what? My father arranged the marriage ceremony of my brother. Really? So you must go. Yes, that's why I am taking preparation. One point, you must take all your nice clothes and ornament with you. Because you can, you are right. He take all ornaments and all nice clothes with him and big bundle and give on the head of Brahmin and going. Now after she gone, then Lakshman Desik crying in front of Bhadi, oh Bharata Jajyo, now I am totally free. Now I can say I am your. Totally I can. After that, wife gone, then he took decision to take sannyas at the bank of Ananta Sarovar in front of the picture of Param Gurudev, Jamunacharya, he took Tridanda Sannyas. Similarly, our Prabhupada took sannyas from Gaur Kishad Das Babaji Maharaj, everybody criticizing. But they don't know eight kind of, you know, expression of Krishna is possible. Picture is also there. Souli, Swaili, Lohi, you know, it is there. Soikati, Monomai, Monimai, different kind. So many. Sri, Lohi, Soikiti, Lepya, Lekhya, Monomai, Monimai, there. Eight kind of. So, picture is also, even picture of Prabhupada is there. If I think Prabhupada is not there, then I am not devotee. When I am giving Pushpanjali, I should think I am giving Pushpanjali directly to Prabhupada. I should have that kind of feeling. Otherwise, our Pushpanjali is useless. This way, he took sannyas, Tridandi sannyas, and this way, we can cross the opinion and Siddhanta of all Babaji is there in Radha Kundu. I can cross their Siddhanta. If you can take me there at the bank of Radha Kundu, arrange one Harikatha, I can break and cross their Siddhanta. They are criticizing about how your Prabhupada taking sin. I can slap them. I am so, you know, proud. Anyway, so Lakshman Dasik took sannyas. After that, his name is now Ramanujacharya. Ramanujacharya now took decision, well, as per the decision of Gurudev, first condition I fulfilled. Second condition, I must make Vasya. How to do? He took information that at Bodha and Vasya escaped secretly, very secretly, there in Kashmir, Nishimha Mandir, one Mandir. That is the, you know, place Mayavadi, they all captured. Then Lakshman Deshi, Ramanujacharya with Kuresh. Kuresh is the second disciple. First disciple, you know, his name I forget. Dasarathi, his cousin, first disciple. Second disciple, Kuresh. Third disciple again, he is missing, nice. After that, Jadavacharya, who was fighting with him for so long, he wanted to kill him. Now, Jadavacharya took advice from mother. His mother was bhakti, full of bhakti. His mother giving instruction, you are doing aparad. Unto the lotus feet of Ramanujacharya, because she is knowing everything about that ghost going, everything, all history. You must go. You must approach Ramanujacharya and take diksha from him. Then all your previous aparad can be excused by Gurudev. Oh, really? Then he is approaching Ramanujacharya. And all its doubts, Ramanujacharya speaking one by one. What is your doubt? Then, Ramanujacharya breaking one by one. After that, Jadavacharya took diksha from Ramanujacharya. His name was Sri Govinda Acharya, like that. Govinda Acharya, like that. Govinda Das. And first at the Govinda, he took his cousin. He took. This way, Lakshman Deshi now expressing mantra rahasya to everybody. I'm making so many disciples. After that, he going with Kuresh. Because Kuresh, in their sampradaya, it is the belief going that Kuresh is Lakshman Avatar, Ram Avatar, Ram Angsha. And Dasarathi is Bharat Angsha, Bharat. Bharat, you know, at Ram Navami day, evening time, I can speak about Ram Tatta, Ram Leela. Very secret Leela. That with Kuresh, Ramanujacharya going, they are to, going all Tirtha, different Tirtha, Badrika, Sram, Allahabad, Varanasi, everywhere, all Tirtha, different. Vrindavan, Puri, everywhere. All, I am not going in details. My time is very limited. So he went there, staying there for 1 or 2 days, requesting, you have Bodhan Basa with you? Can you give? No, Bodhan Basa off. We don't know where is Bodhan Basa, but Bodhan Basa is there. They capture it. But they straightway speaking lie. No, Bodhan Basa is not there. Bodhan Basa lost long ago. We know nothing about the whereabout of that Bodhan Basa. Excuse us. Then at night time, Ramanujacharya crying and Nisingadev appeared in front of Ramanujacharya. From Almira, secret place, Nisingadev taking this Bodhan Basa and keep giving in the hand of Lakshman. You take Ramanujacharya. Now go quickly. I give it to your hand. Go and make Basa. Nisingadev disappear. In the morning time they discover that Basa was there, that place is empty. Where is Basa? Search him. They find one very powerful man, 10-12, search them. We like to kill them. If somehow Bodhan Basa is exposed, our Mayavad Basa cannot stand. And 10-12 person running here on the hilly place. 1 month after, they catch them and fight with them. But Ramanujacharya is so powerful, incarnation of Lakshman, they can beat them, but he is Vaishnava, we don't fight with them. Well, what you want? Give this Bodhan Basa, snatch and go away, beat them. After that, Ramanujacharya now crying, what to do? Kuresh, somehow by the grace of, you know, Nisingadev, I get the chance to read that Bodhan Basa, but now is gone. Kuresh smiles, laughing. Gurudev, don't think. Why? By this Bodhan Basa, I already memorized. Memorized? How? In 1 month, when you are sleeping, I reading. I memorize everything. I can write. You can write? Now you write now. I'm writing everything as it is. Without any stop and full stop, dot, everything. So high memory power. Writing. Then Ramanujacharya coming and making one nice vasya of Vedanta. Then his second condition fulfilled. Third condition, Parasarisi, making one nice Puran, he want to make one dictionary. Vaishnava Abhidhan, you know Gaudiya Vaishnava Abhidhan? You don't know? You are foolish actually. Maharaj knowing, Maharaj old man, senior. Gaudiya Vaishnava Abhidhan, written by Haridas Baba. All Vaishnava term you can get. Anything you cannot realize, you can open dictionary, you can get. According to nomenclature, according to place, according to title, all different kind of indexes there. Our Prabhupada wanted to make one dictionary, Gaudiya Vaishnava Manjusha. Vaishnava Manjusha. One part I think, published, I think. Prabhupada spending his life, Prabhupada at the last moment speaking, if my Vaishnava Manjusha, this, my plan to complete this dictionary, if not fulfilled in this life, and I will have to come again. Yes, Prabhupada told last time. I will have to come specially to compile Vaishnava Manjusha. It is my promise. Prabhupada spending his life, whole life for us. But we are not grateful. We are cheater actually. Prabhupada wanted to give so many things to us. We are so, you know, we have many of his books by written by Prabhupada, secret books. Against party, they throw in Ganga, you don't know. You know nothing about it. Not published. Not published, Prabhupada writing. Diary, everything. But against party who went, those who went against Prabhupada, they took all, you know, written scriptures, they went to meet Ganga and throw from, you don't know the secrecy. You know nothing about it. We know from our old Guru Varga. All, mane, big, big Guru Varga, my Guru Maharaj, Santu Maharaj, Nayanananda Baba, Giri Maharaj, you know, Govinda Maharaj, so old, old Vaishnav. By chance, I was lucky to meet them. By that time, Kesava Maharaj gone anyway, but still I am lucky. They give me darshan by tatta. I am also lucky what to do. Because in my childhood, I used to go to Gauriamath with my grandmother. So I am the first man to go to Gauriamath before you. Childhood. When I was very small, my grandmother used to take to Gauriamath. Bagbear Gauriamath, Calcutta, used to take me. Oh, come with me. So I'm lucky anyway. So this way, you see, as you know, Prabhupada, even Lakshman Desik compiled this. And second dictionary, on the basis of, you know, Parasar Rishi's Puran, he wanted to compile. This compiled. And so many books written by Ramanuja Charya. Now I like to speak so many things, but I cannot cross this ocean. So last moment I like to speak something special about his Siddhanta, Shuddhadvaita. What? Shuddho? Vishishtadvaita. Vishishtadvaita, not Shuddhadvaita. Vishishtadvaita. Vishishtadvaita by Ramanuja Charya. Advaitabad is already approved by Lakshman Desi, but some speciality is there. That's why Vishishta Advaita. Badanti tattattavidam jadgyanam adhyayam bhagavatam. Advaitabad is okay. Ramanuja Jove. But there is some speciality. That's why Vishishta Advaita. In Vishishta Advaita, if I like to discuss this philosophy, long philosophy, I can touch only. Chit, Achit and Supreme Lord, three factors. Ramanujacharya want to speak that how Mayavadi Sampradaya can speak this way, that Brahma is distorted and this is the form of Brahma, is distorted form. No! Ramanujacharya speaking, in milk, there is every possibility of butter. If you churn, then automatically from milk, butter can come. That's mean, butter is there. But you cannot see. When you churn, then butter coming. So, what Ramanujacharya want to speak is just equal to latest scientific research, you know, cause and effect. Cause and effect. Latest scientific research, they 100% believe this factor, they prove that potency should be there. Because if potency is not there, how you are getting this matter from? Suppose I take a bucket of water and churn, I cannot get butter. Whereas if I churn milk, I can get butter. That means in milk, the potency is there. If potency is not there, there is no possibility that you can get. So cause and effect mean action can prove that what is that object can prove the action and it is have correlated. Ramanujacharya wanted to prove this thing. That if this material world coming, how coming? Ramanujacharya speaking, chit. Chit means transcendental. Chit particle or jivatma. Achit. Achit means matter. Chit means all jivatma. And achit means all matters. Though in Vrindavan I cannot speak this matter, it's wrong Siddhanta, I am bound to speak what to do. Matter. You know, any matter. Ramanujan want to speak that chit, achit, and Brahma. Brahma means Advaya, but Advaya still we can believe that diversity is there. Advaya means no Advaya. One, Brahma, is okay. But Brahma can stay in formless condition, also in form, you know, nice transcendental, you know, feature we can see. Both possible. Both is possible. So Ramanujaja speaking that you see that this chid, jivatma, and this achid, this matter, and Brahma all correlated. Is a jiv and matter is a title, visheshan. In Sanskrit or Bengali we say visheshan. Visheshan means adjective. Visheshan means adjective. Like you are a man, you are very fair man. Man is very, it's adjective, your fairness. I have one black dog, black cow, a title of cow. So this way, title means visheshan. So Ramanujaja wanted to prove that this chit, this all jivatma, all the achit, those matter, and Brahma, all correlated. No doubt in it. I can prove by Vedanta Sutta. In Bhashya, he's writing on in details, all in details. Very nice explanation. And they, I like to speak so many things, but time cannot permit that arti time over, almost. But in their sampradaya, Lakshmi Narayan is topmost. They cannot cross this limit because they have some limit set by Krishna. Ramanujaja cannot cross this limit. Matajaja cannot cross this limit. Dvaitadvaita Siddhanta cannot cross this limit. Nimbarkajaja cannot cross this limit. Up to certain limit they are, you know, given instruction. Up to that point they can do their duty. But after that, when our Gauriya Guru Varga coming, Baladev Buddha Vasan all coming, they can exposing some more and more secrecy. For that you cannot say that secrecy is totally false because Ramanujaja not saying, Matajaja not saying, you cannot speak this way. Because they are giving instruction by Krishna up to that point. After that, more secrecy, you know, we can get from our Sara Goswami and everything. So how you can fight with us? It's not true. And when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, though Chaitanya Mahaprabhu not making any new sampradaya, because sampradaya, to make one sampradaya, it is not duty, it is not the duty of Supreme Lord. It is not the duty of Supreme Lord to make one new sampradaya. Only Krishna can sampradaya, you know, can be erected by your very, very nice devotee. So anyway, parikrama, regarding parikrama, you know, topics I was discussing there, Madhvacharya, Ramanujacharya, everybody, they went, Madhvacharya also went there, I already told, in parikrama, in Gaurapurnima time. So Madhvacharya, that time Gauranga Mahaprabhu not coming, long ago. 938 Shakabdo, that time. And Khrishtabdo, I cannot, I will have to calculate actually. I don't know.
1001.
Calculate. Some personal calculation is there. So you see, long ago. So still, when Madhvacharya going to Navadip Dham, that time, when he is doing bhajan, then Gauranga Mahaprabhu appear, golden complexion, blessing you. Well, shortly I am coming to this Navadip Dham, and then I can accept your sampradaya. Oh really, I can do kripa to you. This way, we accept Madhva Sampradaya, but we speak this way, Madhva Gauriya Sampradaya. Because Gauranga Mahaprabhu giving Achinta Vedavetatta is very nice Siddhanta. Gauranga Mahaprabhu balancing all the different, you know, Siddhantas of all four Acharyas, balancing and giving one nice, you know, mode. Very nice mode. This way, we are going to identify ourselves that we are from Madhva Gauriya Sampradaya. Somebody unnecessarily fighting with us that Madhva Gauriya Sampradaya, how possible? Why not possible? But only when Baladev Vidyabhushan from Madhva Sampradaya, changing his Sampradaya, coming to Gauriya Sampradaya, he wanted to make one link with Madhva Sampradaya. No! Not that. Jiva Goswami Pad, Rupa Goswami Pad, all our PBS Acharya, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they all giving evidence, different evidence there. Baladev Vidyabhushan writing nice, you know, there he is writing his parampara mode. We can get everything in details, but they are unnecessarily fighting with us. But your sampradaya is new, started from Gauranga Mahaprabhu. No, not at all. Who told? Who told? They are giving all false argument. Even when Sundaranda Vidyavan is living Prabhupada, he is writing all opposite. All just opposite of what? Just opposite of what he wrote before by the mercy of Prabhupada. Totally opposite. He is breaking his own Siddhanta. What to do? Anyway, we are sorry, very sorry to speak. We are very sorry. We are crying day and night. That we are, you know, we cannot do actual seva of Prabhupada. If anybody like to do actual seva of Prabhupada, they should follow Prabhupada perfectly and expose the Siddhanta and mode and characteristics of Prabhupada. Everything should be exposed. Not that we can say, Jai Prabhupada! And backside we can say, Ah, Prabhupada, you can go to hell. If Prabhupada is there, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is there, we cannot run Gauriya Math. Who telling? Huh? Bloody? Speaking this way. They are speaking this way. If we like to follow Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we cannot run Gauriya Math. Whereas we heard from Guru Bharga, Gauriya Math is the only place where you can stay if you are going to obey all the instruction of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. I mean, Gauriya Math is equal to Bhaktivinoda Thakur plus Prabhupada. Gauriya Math is equal to Bhaktivinoda Thakur plus Prabhupada. That is Gauriya Math. And you want to violate their instruction? Huh? It's not good. So we should fight. We should give whole life for the, you know, for the cause of Prabhupada. Because we cannot touch, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is so long distance. We can touch Prabhupada. Prabhupada can bless us because my Param Gurudev is Prabhupada. Though I feel shy to identify because I am useless, but still. Anyway, Aarti time is over. If you have any question, but yesterday, I just forget one thing. Please excuse me, first of all, that it was not Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya defeated second Shankaracharya. I forget. I feel confused actually. Second Shankaracharya was defeated by Madhvacharya. But be careful, Shankaracharya took birth much before first Shankaracharya. Yeah. He appeared there in Kerala. Karnad one place, I forget this name. Karnad, you know, I forget. But that, you see, second Shankaracharya is same Shankaracharya. Because in their parampara, it is written, Shankaracharya took new birth. Then Kesava Goswami Maharaj fighting them, Mayavadi. You foolish idiot, how you speak this way? Shankaracharya took new birth. You are breaking your own Siddhanta? Mayavadi people, they are very puzzled. How? You now speaking Shankaracharya, you know, he is attending Brahma Nirvana. Second time you are speaking Shankaracharya, getting taking second part, then you are breaking your own Siddhanta. You are breaking your own, how possible? Who is already submerged with Brahma, who is, what is their possibility? How is this possible? It's coming. So you are breaking your own, you are idiot number one, foolish number one. So, one point I forget, excuse me. Yes, so many tattva is there. I like to speak, but I get confused, you see. Time is very limited. Tomorrow we can discuss some new point, actually. Today, if you have any question, you can put before me. Otherwise, I can stop my speech here. A small discussion. What, Maharaj?
Can you repeat the two things Mahaprabhu took from each acharya, sampradaya, sacharya?
I can speak tomorrow, but today I can, because arati time is over. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took this point that Madhacharya, why we accept Madhacharya? Madhacharya believe that deity, of course, deity, satya, I mean, eternal. This is unbhakti. Their bhakti, bhajan, eternal, this belief. And all three, four acharya, I can see one or two points. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur already told it. I can speak. Vancha kalpa durvasya kipa sindh bevacha patitanam pavane bho vashna bhyo namon. Purushottam, you can add this last point with yesterday's speech. Yesterday, when I finish Vancha kalpa durvasya, you can add last point. Tomorrow 5 o'clock, but day after tomorrow, I mean Ramnavami day, three speech there. First speech 10 o'clock there in Chaitanya Gauri Math, Madhugusi and 11:30 here. Yeah, and evening time about Ramchandra Tatta. Three time, first here, second and third here. Because you know that Acharya, you know, Ashram Maharaj, is I think Disappearance Day, here.
How many more days you speak for?
I can speak about them.
How many more days you speak here?
I can three. I mean 11 o'clock, 11:30.
No, how many days from today? Like tomorrow?
Yes. After that, I am leaving for. I have so many seva there, I am coming because I have nothing to do. Okay. Hey, Pujari. Suru karo. Vancha kalpadarvasya kipa sindh bhavacha. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Krishna Hare Hare Pore Divi Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Nitai Gaur Hari Bo Hari Bo Hari Bo Hari Bo Gaur Hari Bo Hari Bo Hari Bo Gaur Hari Bol, Nitai Gaur Hari Bol, Govindanandi.
Ace Krishna, Govinda Gopal.